Hello, it's Jennifer Harding Marlin, a citizenship by investment attorney, and today's video is going to talk in detail about the Saint Kitts and Nevis Citizenship by Investment Program, especially since there have been a lot of recent changes to the program. So the Saint Kitts and Nevis Citizenship by Investment Program started in 1984, and the purpose for starting the program was to attract foreign investments to the country in order to boost the economy. When it was first established, it was a sugar investment diversification foundation and real estate options for citizenship. And since its initial inception, there's been a lot of popularity and a lot of success with the program, and so there have been legislative changes as well as regulations in place to maintain the integrity and reputation of the program, as Saint Kitts and Nevis is recognized as the platinum brand. So by becoming a citizen of Saint Kitts and Nevis, there are multiple advantages, and a lot of top entrepreneurs have chosen to do the Saint Kitts and Nevis Citizenship by Investment Program. So some of the advantages include that Saint Kitts and Nevis is a politically and economically stable country. It's a really safe place to live. I personally feel very safe in Saint Kitts and Nevis. It's a tax favorable country. There's no personal income tax and or inheritance tax. So some people choose to relocate to the country and take advantage of the tax advantages of being a resident of Saint Kitts and Nevis. For wealth preservation and asset protection purposes. And then you have the right to live and work in the country as a citizen. There are international schools, medical schools, and veterinarian school here. So there's a lot of international persons that do come and spend time in Saint Kitts and Nevis. And then with the passport, you have increased mobility and ability to travel for business and leisure, and the ability to pass on citizenship to your future children and or a future spouse. And so these are just some of the advantages of becoming a citizen of Saint Kitts and Nevis. So to be eligible for Saint Kitts and Nevis citizenship, the main applicant needs to be minimum age of 18 years of age and must have a clean background. You cannot be denied citizenship of another country, and provided you have been denied a visa to a country where Saint Kitts and Nevis has visa-free travel and you haven't been able to reapply and successfully obtain a visa, then this is grounds for you to not be accepted as a citizen. And who can be included in an application for citizenship includes the spouse of the main applicant. So you do need to be married with a valid marriage certificate. Saint Kitts and Nevis does not recognize common law marriage for the purposes of doing the program. You can include children below the age of 18 years of age. Children that are between the ages of 18 and 25 need to be financially dependent on the main applicant and enrolled in school. So you'll need to provide a confirmation of enrollment letter that your children are in school, provided they are in school. And then you can include parents and grandparents that are above the age of 65 who are financially dependent on the main applicant and who live and are fully supported by the main applicant. So this just gives you an idea of who can be included in an application for Saint Kitts and Nevis citizenship. Nationalities that are prohibited from doing Saint Kitts and Nevis citizenship, it changes on an ongoing basis, but if you're from Iran, North Korea, Afghanistan, Iraq, Russia, or Belarus, for example, so there are different pathways to obtaining Saint Kitts and Nevis citizenship by investment. One of them is making a non-refundable contribution into the Sustainable Island State Contribution, which is very new. And it involves a minimum non-refundable investment of US$250,000 for a single applicant, or US$300,000 for a couple, and US$350,000 for a family of four. In addition to the donation, non-refundable donation, there's also due diligence fees of US$10,000 for the main applicant and US$7,500 for anyone who's 16 years of age and older, as well as other fees, including legal agent fees, to process the citizenship by investment application. There's also the option to invest in government-approved real estate, starting at $400,000, and it's really important that it is, in fact, government-approved for citizenship. In addition to the real estate investment, there is a donation fee of US$25,000 the main applicant, US$15,000 the spouse, US$10,000 for anyone who's 18 years of age and below, and or US$15,000 for anyone who's 18 years of age and older. There's also a private home sales option So you can invest $400,000 into an approved condominium and or $800,000 into a private home. And these under the real estate option, you cannot sell the real estate for 7 years. So you need to maintain the real estate for 7 years. Additionally, there is donation fee and legal fees that are applicable. If you want a cost quote specific to your case, you can get in touch with us at jhmarlin.com. And there's also a public goods option for citizenship, which operates similarly to the investment donation option under the Sustainable Island State Contribution option. So these are just a quick summary of the costs and what it takes to do citizenship by investment. There's quite a lot of documents that are involved. You'll need to get documents notarized, and in some cases, documents apostilled. You need to provide proof of address where you're living, provide bank statements, professional reference letters, amongst other documents. And we can provide you a specific list of documents specific to your case when you become a client and are interested in pursuing citizenship. And so there's a lot of top entrepreneurs like Roger Veer from Bitcoin.com, Heidi Shackos from CryptoTips, and Pavlov, who founded Telegram, who are citizens of St. Kitts and Nevis. And a lot of top entrepreneurs choose the St. Kitts and Nevis Citizenship by Investment Program because of its reputation, and as well because a lot of top entrepreneurs have chosen the program specifically for the benefits of being a citizen of St. Kitts and Nevis. St. Kitts and Nevis is a wonderful place to live and visit and spend time in as well. A lot of the times you don't have to come to the country to be able to become a citizen. However, it is definitely worth visiting, and we hope to see you on the island. Bye for now. Thank you.